Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And looking at the AI settings here, I definitely got to make some adjustments to these sliders because I don't want to be blowing out these teams already in season three. So one thing that I noticed in that game is that the blocking just isn't good enough for the computer. It seems as though my guys are just overpowering them at the line of scrimmage, and it may be just that we had a good game. If you look at my rush defense, it's at zero and the pass coverage is at 20. So, but I think I want to make adjustments to the run blocking and pass blocking simply because running back ability is already at 90. I think 90 is actually pretty good. I don't want to put it at 100 because I know they'll be breaking every single tackle. So I'm actually going to put this up to about 70 and see how this game goes for both pass blocking and run blocking. I don't want them to be overpowering, but I do want them to be good. I mean, because think about it, we're going up against Wisconsin this week. I want Wisconsin to play like Wisconsin. I want all these teams to play like they do. I want the pass blocking with these spread offenses to be pretty good because that's what they specialize in. They specialize in pass blocking. So I don't think I need to make any other changes. Maybe rush defense. I'm probably going to put this up. I want to see what it's like on 100, honestly. I want to see what it's like on 100. I'm going to make it difficult. You guys may say, well, that may be way too difficult, but we'll see this game. I don't really know how it's going to play out, but I like that going into this game. I did play on 100 for about the fourth. I switched it to 100 during the fourth quarter of last game, and it didn't really seem to really do too much. Maybe it didn't kick in or something, but I definitely changed it, and it seemed like it was a little better. I just don't want to be overpowering, and especially since I have a high-powered offense, I don't want to be overpowering. So we're going up against Wisconsin this week. They already lost one game, but if you look at it, we got the number one rush defense in the nation after the first week. Look at that, 17 yards we gave up total last game, and I'm sure that's going to change going up against Wisconsin. They played Bama week one and got blown out 20-52. Going up against us, and then they're going up against Ohio State and Michigan back to back. So they open up the schedule with four tough games right off the bat. But if you look at how they did in the first game, Hornibrook was just horrible. 18-32, an interception, didn't do anything really on the ground. He had 20 yards rushing. Then Jonathan Taylor is his usual self, 124 yards rushing. But for some reason in this game, Wisconsin just doesn't play as well as they should. I don't know what it is. A burst user, I mean, they play all right. I mean, because they got to run the ball. But in the grand scheme of things, they never finish as like a top 10 team, just like they do in real life. They never do. So Kirk Herbstreit is picking Wisconsin in this game. But let's just hop into this, man. We got the number one rush defense. We got to keep that up. So let's get into it. Let's go. So Wisconsin is going to start out this game with the ball. Remember, they're at Camp Randall. So we're probably expecting a different outcome than last year. We're just expecting them to play a lot harder because Hornibrook is actually in his senior season this year. And then Jonathan Taylor is going to be another force for another year. So here we go. We get them to punt the ball on the first drive. They come out throwing the ball, which is kind of surprising, getting out of their element a little bit. But here we are on offense, getting the ball to Kevin Oliver on the slant pattern over the middle to convert the first down. So here on a second and four, Cohen's going to throw across the field, find Eddie McCray. It's so funny now. Now that I know he's got that 99 catching, I'm always getting him the ball when I need a reliable catch. But here's another reliable man, the newcomer, Jamel Cooley, coming off that huge game to open up the season. He gets the catch, and here he is, back-to-back catches. So now facing a first and 10 inside the 15-yard line. Eddie McCray getting open inside the 5-yard line. So facing a first and goal now, running a slant pattern, but this time Ben Miller is on the outside where Jamel Cooley would be. Remember, I do a lot of subs. I want to make sure I get some fresh guys out there. So Ben Miller subs in at the wide out position, and he gets the touchdown catch. But on the ensuing possession for Wisconsin, Cephas gets a catch that time. And look at Josh Dunbar. He just straight up loses the ball. And that's one thing I love about NCAA football, is that that stuff doesn't happen in Madden anymore. Doesn't happen, you know, in the recent football games. Usually that stuff, it's very robotic. Like the computer either like makes the play or they just like, you know, act stupid. But that time it seemed like he turned around and lost the ball. It's just the little things with this game that makes it so great. And look at Pittman getting the reception, getting in for the end, into the touchdown, in for the touchdown. And what's funny is that, you know, playing the way I play, I don't switch at all on defense. It's so much fun. I gotta tell you, if you play this dynasty, you gotta do that on defense. It makes the experience so much better. And here we are, back out on offense. Alex Brown getting stuffed that time, but you know me, I'm gonna go for it on a fourth down if I have Alex Brown. And look at my offensive line creating a nice hole that time for Alex Brown for the first down. So now facing a first and 10 at about the 35-yard line, Alex Brown's gonna get the counter, get to the outside for the nice 36-yard gain on that one. And man, my offensive line is doing numbers as the game goes on here in the first quarter. And the first drive, I tried to run the ball. I wasn't very successful. That's why I was throwing the ball a lot. And that's why you'll see me throw the ball, because sometimes, you know, the defense pretty much crowds the line of scrimmage to stop Alex Brown. It's like they know he's going to do well. But here, Alex Brown's getting for the touchdown. But look at Buck Kilgore, the freshman, straight destroying their impact linebacker. And that helps Brown out on the way for the touchdown. So here we are up 14-7 in this game. And here is Wisconsin. They're starting to throw the ball a lot more this season. I don't know what it is, but it seems like in years past, they were just giving the ball to Jonathan Taylor, and right on cue, he gets a long run on that one. But I've seen like a lot of pass plays up to this point. Look at that. They're passing on a first and 10. Last two seasons gotcha, I played bitch. Them, they were running the ball. But look at Hunter Greggs, another newcomer, the freshman, getting in for the sack. And look at the work he has to do to get in for this sack. He has to get around Jonathan Taylor, get around the left guard first, and then gets in for the sack. So now facing a third and 15, Hornibrook throwing to the outside, but that's only going to be a 5-yard gain. If he would have waited a little bit longer, he maybe would have had a streaker open, but they attempt a field goal and they miss. So Marquette catches a break and back out on offense, running a rare read option, getting up to the 50-yard line is Ashton Cohen. So facing a first and 10, look at this offensive line. I mean, they are just forming holes for Alex Brown early on as the game goes on. But here he is getting involved in the passing game. But look at this move he puts on the defender. And he gets an 8-yard reception that time. So facing a second and 13, 2 minutes left in this half. Kevin Oliver is going to get the catch, get inside the 5-yard line. And another handoff. Alex Brown getting in for the touchdown. And, I mean, look at this offensive line. Look at Buck Kilgore once again just pushing this guy back into the secondary and creating a great wall, a great hole for Alex Brown to go through. But on the ensuing possession, AJ Taylor gets behind the Marquette defense, and that was just busted coverage that time. And Alex Hornibrook finds his receiver getting open for the touchdown. So now it's back down to a 7-point lead, but there's enough time for us to drive down this field. So I'm going to do everything I can to do that. And here's Ashton Cohen getting to the outside, getting a nice 20-yard scramble that time. And Alex Brown on the ground, another 12-yard gain. I mean, this offensive line, we don't have the best rated offensive line, but they are opening up holes in this first half. And here they are once again. Alex Brown gets through a hole, but gets tripped up before getting into the end zone. But there's a little bit of time left, and we do kick the field goal. So we go into half up 10 points. So after a nice return by Chad Ball to open up the second half, Ashton Cohen rolling out left, getting the nice 10-yard gain that time. So now facing a third and 10 a couple of plays later, Ashton Cohen's going to roll out, but he's going to get rid of this ball, throw it out of bounds. So Davis is going to come in and convert the field goal. And here we are, up two scores now, 13 points. And now Wisconsin finally getting back to their ways, running the ball up the middle with Jonathan Taylor for the 15-yard gain. So facing a first and 10, Hornibrook's going to throw once again. And this one is going to be picked off, this time by Vince Cohen. And like I said, what is Wisconsin doing? They are getting away from their game plan, getting away from what they do best, and trying to throw the ball with Hornibrook. But we all know Hornibrook isn't a great passer. He's a decent passer, not great. not really good at all. I mean, he's just decent. So they're not giving the ball to Jonathan Taylor. And look, we're capitalizing on offense here once again. Another big hole for Alex Brown. So now facing a first and 10 inside the 20-yard line. Ben Miller getting the reception on the outside that time inside the 10-yard line. So now facing a first and goal. Look at this hole that opens up. This offensive line is doing a number in this matchup. The Battle of Wisconsin. And now we go up 20 points in Wisconsin. I mean, just trying to do something on offense, but I mean, their best bet is running the ball. But now that they're down three scores, they got to start passing the ball. But that's going to be a mistake with Paul Miller back there. Another newcomer with the interception. And he has the awareness to keep his feet in bounds as well. So we take over and we're doing a little different things here, getting a screen pass this time to Ben Miller that time, and he's getting inside about the 25-yard line. So facing a first and 10, I sub the second team offense into the game, and what is Jimmy Ward, number 34, getting in for the touchdown. And man, what a great offensive game we are having. Even our second team offensive line is doing great. But here's Hornibrook. I mean, just trying to throw the ball deep, get some points on the board. But I do have my second team defense back out on the field. But here they are on a 3rd and 7. I send a cover 0, and that's going to be caught for the touchdown this time by Pryor. So they do have to kick an onside kick, and we recover the ball. Kevin Oliver, but pay attention to this play. Flag on the play. It's illegal touching on Wisconsin, but look at the acceptance penalty. It's on our own 36, and I hit it on accident instead of declining it. So I had to start this drive on our own 36. But, I mean, no problem. I mean, because of the game that our offensive line is having, we're having no problems moving the sticks, and Jimmy Ward running over the defensive end on that one. But now we need to see what Joshua Rich can do, because he's our backup quarterback. But here he's starting out his series here going 0-for-3. So we do have to punt the ball away. So I sub back in my first team defense because I at least need to make a stop. It's a 20-point game, 4 minutes left. You never know what can happen. But John Waters on the second play from scrimmage gets the interception. And man, another newcomer. I mean, all these newcomers are showing up in this game. And we eventually capitalize here with 40 seconds left, giving the ball to Jimmy Ward. And he straight punishes the linebacker on that one, lays them out flat. And that is going to do it. Marquette, what a great game in this one by our offensive line. I mean, they are just the unsung heroes of this game. And I mean, this was just an all-around effort. We only had one sack this game by Hunter Greggs. But I mean, the surprise of this game was that Wisconsin didn't elect to run the ball more. They only gave Jonathan Taylor 11 carries in this one, and he didn't reach 100 yards. I mean, he's been beasting us the first two seasons, but this game, they only give it to him for 11 attempts, 95 yards, and Hornibrook throws for 3 touchdowns, but also throws 3 interceptions, and that is proving to be one of the storylines of this season. Our defense is just showing up, pass rush, through the air, pass defense, rush defense, all around. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. We're going into conference play next week, so you don't want to miss that one. Let's go.